For the U.S., Xi Jinping's trip to Russia is providing the Kremlin diplomatic cover to commit further crimes. The U.S. and its Western allies have largely dismissed China's 12-point proposal on Ukraine as a ploy to buy Vladimir Putin more time to regroup his forces and solidify his grip on occupied land. The White House says Xi should also speak with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky about the impact of the war.
If China is committed to supporting an end to the war based on the principles of the UN Charter, as called for in point one of its plan, it can engage with President Zelensky and Ukraine on the basis and use its influence to compel Moscow to pull back its forces. Calling for a ceasefire that does not include the removal of Russian forces from Ukrainian territory would effectively be supporting the ratification of Russian conquest. It would recognize Russia's attempts to seize the sovereign neighbor's territory by force. The world should not be fooled by any tactical move by Russia, supported by China or any other country, to freeze the war on its own terms.
Chinese President Xi Jinping wraps up day one of his visit to Moscow with a meeting with Russian President Vladimir Putin. Putin told Xi that Russia studied China's peace plan for Ukraine. Beijing had released a broad 12-point proposal to solve the Ukraine crisis, which includes a call for respect for the territorial sovereignty of all countries.
We have carefully studied your proposals on settling the acute crisis in Ukraine. Of course, we'll have an opportunity to discuss these issues. We know that you're guided by observing the principles of justice and respect for the basics of international law, undivided security for every country. You're also well aware that we're always open for a negotiation process. We will discuss all these issues, including your initiative.
This is Xi's first trip since securing an unprecedented third term this month as China's leader. It also comes just days after the International Court issued an arrest warrant against Putin for war crimes. Beijing has dubbed the visit as a journey of peace, but many see it as a strategic move in the Asian country's plan to counter the West. The Philippines and China will hold a dialogue to discuss maritime issues between the two countries. The two-day meeting will be held in Manila this week, beginning March 23rd. It comes amid dozens of diplomatic protests from Manila over Beijing's intrusion and harassment in Philippine waters. Aside from developments in the West Philippine Sea, Manila says the talks will also cover economic issues. Leading Beijing's delegation is Chinese Vice Foreign Minister Sun Weidong. Philippines and the U.S. set to reveal additional military bases in the Southeast Asian country that American soldiers will be allowed to use. The 2014 Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, gave U.S. forces access to 5 bases in the Philippines. It was expanded this year to 9, but the locations of the 4 more bases have not been revealed as the government consults with local officials.
The One Defense AAP team looks forward to the timely completion of all EDCA projects, considering that those facilities would greatly help the Armed Forces of the Philippines boost its capability to ensure the country's defense. Most importantly, the facilities would contribute to the national effort in securing our country's sovereignty and territorial integrity, particularly in our maritime domain awareness campaign.
U.S. Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall hailing the improving alliance between Washington and Manila. He is in the Philippines to lead a groundbreaking ceremony for the rehabilitation of the Basa Air Base runway in Pampanga.
Today's event is a physical manifestation of our Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, a key pillar of the U.S.-Philippine alliance. It builds on our mutual defense treaty that applies anywhere in the South China Sea or the West Philippine Sea. As Secretary Austin noted in his trip here last month, our alliance makes both of our democracies more secure and helps uphold a free and open Indo-Pacific.
The top defense officials of the U.S. and the Philippines hold a phone call to discuss a wide range of issues. A statement from the Pentagon says Secretary Lloyd Austin underscored Washington's unwavering commitment to its military alliance with Manila. The two officials also condemned China's gray zone tactics in Philippine waters. The defense chiefs also welcomed the upcoming military exercises between the Philippines and the United States next month, with 17,000 troops set to participate. The two then discussed measures to contain the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. Secretary Austin also offered condolences to the family of slain Negros Oriental Governor Roel De Gamo. Donors pledged 7 billion euros more than a month since devastating quakes hit Turkey and Syria. The February 6 tremors were the worst natural disaster to strike modern-day Turkey, killing over 56,000 people. The European Union and Sweden organized the fundraiser.
This conference has provided promises of support to institutions and organizations that aim to help people whose lives were destroyed in a matter of seconds and minutes. But even more, your commitments today have also provided the necessary fuel that all human beings in all countries need in difficult situations, and that is hope. Hope that rebuilding dignity and everyday life will be possible.
E-commerce giant Amazon is cutting 9,000 jobs in a second round of mass layoffs. Amazon CEO Andy Jassy announced the job cuts Monday, saying economic uncertainties have forced the company to streamline costs and headcount. This follows a massive layoff in January, which saw 18,000 job cuts. This round will mainly impact Amazon's cloud computing, human resources, and advertising departments.